Today, I will be explaining you the poem, A Tiger in the Zoo, written by Leslie Norris. First of all, we'll come to know that what are the key points of this poem? What exactly is the theme of this poem? In this poem, the poet tries to depict the mental condition of a caged tiger. He compares the life of a tiger in the zoo with its life in its natural habitat. The poet conveys an important message that the wild animals should be in their natural habitat, and in the poem, he heightens the contrast between freedom and captivity. Means how an animal feels when he is free and how the animal feels when it is in captivity. The poet very impressively shows us how love for freedom is the natural instinct of every living being. The poet is successful in showing us what the value of freedom to us is. Now we'll move to line-wise explanation of the poem. The first line of the poem is, he stalks in his vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage, on pads of velvet quiet, in his quiet rage. The poet here is telling that the tiger stalks, the tiger walks in under his vivid stripes, means colorful skin, the few steps of his cage, and he is able to move only a few steps in his cage because the cage is quite small. On pads of velvet quiet, here the pads of velvet quiet means his paws. His paws are very soft and they are very quiet because they do not produce any kind of sound. In his quiet rage. And he also says the tiger is quiet but he is angry. Rage here means anger. Now we'll quickly look the literary devices of this. First of all, we'll go through the rhyme scheme of the entire poem stanza wise. It is ABCB. Rhyme scheme is decided on the basis of the last word of the line, of each line. Here, as you can see, that in the first line, stripes, second line, cage, third line, quiet, and fourth line, rage. Here we can see stripes is rhyming with quiet and cage is rhyming with rage. So if we give this thing A, then we'll give this B, and then we'll have to give this C, not C. The rhyme scheme will be A, B, A, B, and then C, and then again B. Because the third one is not rhyming with the first one, so we are making it C. The first figure of speech which we come across in this is personification. In this figure of speech, non-human things are personified. Here, the tiger is personified. Second figure of speech we come across is metaphor. Here, tiger's paws are compared with velvet. Okay. They are compared with velvet. So here it is metaphor. Oxymoron. Oxymoron when two opposite things are mentioned in the same line. Here we can see quiet and rage. Means anger also and being quiet also. Now we move to the second stanza of the poem. It is, he should be lurking in shadow. The poet says that the tiger should be lurking in shadow, somewhere in forest, in jungle, sliding through long grass. And the tiger should also keep on sliding through long grasses as it does when it is about to attack its prey. Near the water hole, the tiger would have been going near the water points where other animals come to quench their thirst, and tiger hunts them where plum deer pass, where the deers come to drink water and the tigers wait for them so that they can hunt them. The tiger should be at that place. Literary devices in this stanza are alliteration. Alliteration is repetition of consonant sound. Okay, here we see plump P and then we see pass P. So here it is alliteration. Second one we see imagery. Imagery is actually the figure of speech in which the poets try to create an image. that when we start thinking of the things as if we are watching them, it is imagery. The third stanza is, he should be snarling around houses. We have heard a number of times that tigers keep on coming to the villages which are situated at the banks of forest. So this tiger who is in the captivity should also be snarling around houses. And he should go to the at the jungle's edge, should reach to the jungle's edge in search of food, bearing his white fangs, his claws. The tiger should open his bare white fangs, his tooth and his claws, terrorizing the village, and he should terrorize the village. The poet wants to say that this cage, this zoo is not the place for this tiger. The actual place of the tiger is the forest, where he should be snarling around the houses which are built around the jungle, and he should show his white fangs and claws and try to terrorize the villagers. The literary devices used in this stanza are onomatopoeia, where the sound word here given is in the first line is snarling. Second one is alliteration, use of sound B at the start of two words. Again, alliteration is repetition of consonant sounds. Here, two words are having B at the start, behind bar. Then we move to the next stanza. But he is locked in a concrete cell. The poet now says that the tiger should be out in jungle, the tiger should be terrorizing the villagers, but what actually is happening? He is out. He is out of the jungle and he is in a cell. He is locked in a cell, stalking the length of his cage, and he is only allowed to move in his cage, ignoring visitors, and he has to ignore the visitors. He is tired of watching people coming and watching him. He is tired of them. So the tigers start ignoring any visitor comes across him. He hardly pays attention. Literary device again is here is personification, as tiger is personified. Though tiger is personified in whole poem. The last stanza is, he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. The last voice, the last noise, the last sound the tiger hears at the end of the day during the night time is the sound of patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars, and he can do nothing except staring at brilliant stars with his brilliant eyes. It is his fate. He cannot do anything else. He can't go out of the zoo, he can't go out of his bars even, and he can't go to the forest, he can't return to his normal routine. Alliteration here is use of sound H in the starting of two words. Again, consonant sounds he hears, H and H repeated. This was the explanation of the poem. To recapitulate the entire poem, we'll see the summary quickly. The poem begins with a description of a tiger. What I said, that its skin is colorful, beautiful, the tiger is, and is walking in his little cage. Because the cage is tiny, he is allowed to move only a few steps. He has beautiful stripes on his skin and has velvet-like soft paws which don't make any sound. But the tiger is not happy because he is captivated and is quite angry. It is angry, but the tiger cannot show his anger. The poet says that if the tiger was not confined to the zoo cage, he would have been hiding himself behind the long grass near some water body and waiting for deers, waiting for its prey. Also, he would have terrorized the villagers of the village which are situated at the bank of the forest. But what the reality is totally opposite to this. Tiger is confined in a cage which was made up of strong material, that is concrete, and the tiger feels helpless there and cannot go out of that. He could not show his power to the visitors. Visitors come and he has no option of showing his power. So what he does? He ignores them. He is tired of watching them, so he starts ignoring them. He says that during night also he is alone. The tiger is alone during night time, and what he hears is the voice of the patrolling vehicles, of people and looking at the stars. He has only two options. First option is he keeps on watching at the brilliant stars with his brilliant eyes, and second thing he does is listening of patrolling cars. The cage life has totally changed the tiger's personality. The poet is trying to say that animal which is famous for its fearlessness and freedom is confined and sad due to the human being who want to derive pleasure by looking at him in the zoo. The poet also wants us to understand that it is an inborn nature of every human being and animals as well that they want to stay free, and we are no one to keep any other person in captivity. I hope the summary is clear, and I hope the lines of the poems explained by me are clear to you. Your comments are most welcomed. Thank you everyone for watching this.